story though is while Mamata Banerjee and the TMC has taken the lead, Mamata Banerjee herself is now trailing by over 8,000 votes after the third round in Nandigram. So what you could actually have is Shubhendu Adhikari consolidating his lead over Didi. So mixed fortunes at the moment for Didi. She could well be the Dada of Bengal, but losing in Nandigram itself. Now, Rahul said that it was a gamble she took and went by instinct, possibly to settle scores with the Adhikari family. But if you asked her what you would choose, winning Bengal or losing Nandigram, she wants to win Bengal. She will, of course, then have suffered a personal defeat at one level, but it will then be a huge victory. So we'll have to see how this plays out. Rahul Verma, fellow at the Center for Policy Research, joining us. Gopal Krishna Agarwal, national spokesperson of the BJP with us. Manu Sundaram and others also still with us. But let's get a first word from you, Rahul Verma. At the moment appears Trinamool Congress edging ahead in Bengal, but Mamata herself trailing. How do you see that? What interpret that for us?
Rajdeep, as you rightly said, if Mamata has to choose between two things, she would like to win Bengal even if she loses Nandigram. I think what we are witnessing at the moment, because these are early leads, this is a tight race and it's likely to remain tight for some more time before we get a clear indication of who's going to lead. And the reasons why this is a tight election are four. First, I think there is equal level of polarization on both sides. And given the demographics of West Bengal, you should expect a tighter race. Mm-hmm. Second, what has happened in this election in West Bengal, that BJP would have expected Congress Left and ISF Alliance to do well, so that they can basically those... that alliance would have largely taken votes away from Trinamool, which has not happened. So Mamata is gaining from this alliance not doing well at all. Third, you have to remember that BJP basically, you know, does really well in national elections and comes down a little bit in state elections, and this is what is happening. So BJP is holding on to its national presence, but is not able to add much more to that. And right. Finally, what many had always said, that Mamata has some advantage among women voters, it seems that this section is still keeping Mamata and her party in the fight.
Big, big story then coming in. Gopal Krishna Agarwal, it appears at the moment you put all your efforts, resources into Bengal. Some would say controversially, way too many resources, but Mamata Banerjee holding on. Didi or Didi is proving there's a bit of a Dada in her.
No, but the thing is that from where we started, it was a tough fight. We started from a very low margin in 2016. From there, we have put all effort. Our all elections are like this. Let the final result come.
Sure, but Gopal, with due regard, Amit Shah was at a press conference in Kolkata, said, "Ab ki baar 200 paar." He was talking of 200 plus. He was saying, we'll get a bigger victory in Bengal than we got in UP. That's not happening clearly. Mamata Banerjee is not going anywhere. She may lose Nandigram, but she is at the moment, showing that she's very much in the race in Bengal.
No, she is in the race. She was always in the race. But the thing is that BJP put up a very strong fight at the ground level. There was a wave of Parivartan flowing there. And if the Mamata Banerjee loses, what face she has? And still there are, these are only initial counting. But the ultimate, I think we are going to perform very well. We are going to form government in West Bengal. We are confident from the ground report what has been coming to us from our workers, leaders there, that there is a big wave of change that is blowing.
So you're still seeing the possibility of a BJP victory in Bengal, am I correct? You're still seeing that, yeah. Very much.
Yes, definitely. We for BJP forming the government in West Bengal is also very important for us. But, and still we are very confident. Okay. On the ground report that we are getting.
So you're saying you're still confident, at Manisha Priyam?
And you see,
Okay, we'll still wait and see. I concede that these are very early rounds. Manisha Priyam, if Mamata Banerjee is at all holding on, what is the reason? Give us a quick, short explanation. Why do you think if she is holding on, what explains her ability to resist this BJP juggernaut?
You know, her ability to resist the BJP juggernaut comes from the fact that the large theory that we have about the BJP taking a bunch of subaltern Hindus for its victory may be a limited and thin one. We might see that many of the gains made in the Jangal Mahal area, for example, amongst the scheduled tribes, were washed away in 2019 in Jharkhand, for example. So a lot of the breakup will tell us that only subaltern Hindutva does not substitute for full Hindutva.
Right.
You needed a combination of all Hindus to be able to take on.
No, no, but it's also true that where the BJP let's be fair. The BJP started as a single digit party with winning just three seats and less than 10% of the vote in 2016. From there, where they've come today, they are obviously a huge gainer as well, as Gopal is suggesting.
And we have also to understand.
Mamata Banerjee's failures in Amphan, definitely something. Mamata Banerjee's failures in Amphan, for example, have cost her a lot in this election. It was hoped that the CPM may have taken away some of that, but one cannot deny the fact that her failures in Amphan relief. Therefore, the huge lesson is that if public leaders, regional or national, will fail during times of natural calamities, large-scale calamities, then any amount of doing development benefits through programs and schemes will not be enough to bring them back to power. At the same time, the effort to consolidate all Hindus and take on a regional leader may not prove sufficient in the permanent settlement areas in the Hindi heartland, and that will be a strategy that the BJP will have to rework, rethink. In Uttar Pradesh, as in West Bengal, the subaltern Hindutva framework had given the BJP an edge that may be under challenge now. The BJP may have to put on other alternative narratives, and those narratives that make a difference to the lives of people.
Okay. You know, the big story emerging from West Bengal at this moment is that you've got Trinamool...